Now we have defined the polynomial on term is monomial. According to this monomial category, only one term appears in that polynomial. That kind of polynomial are said to be monomial, like 100x raised to 15, 5 by 7, y raised to 10, and so on and so forth. That kind of polynomials are said to be monomial. And if we are talking about binomial, there are two terms appear there in that polynomial. Doesn't matter what is the power, number of terms should be 2. That kind of polynomial are said to be binomial, like this x square minus 4, 2x plus 7, or x cube minus 27, whatever. Similarly, trinomial. In this type of polynomial, we have 3 terms, like x square plus 5x plus 6. We have 3 terms, that's why we have called it trinomial. So on term basis, we know that number of terms decides the way of polynomial. Now we are focusing on zero of a polynomial. Zero of a polynomial. First, we are giving the definition of this. That value of variable x is said to be zero of a polynomial which convert that polynomial into zero. Like, suppose we have a polynomial px is x cube minus 7x minus 6, and we are putting here x equals to minus 1. So what we get? Minus 1 raised to 3 minus 7 into minus 1 minus 6, that is minus 1 plus 7 minus 6. 7 minus 7 becomes 0. When we put in the value of x minus 1 in this polynomial, we get that the value of p x is 0. That's why we are saying that x minus 1, x equals to minus 1 is a 0 of this polynomial. तो mean यह zero of a polynomial का कि x variable की वो value polynomial में put करना जो उस polynomial को zero में convert कर दे, उस चीज को हम बोलते हैं zero of a polynomial. How many zeros occurs there for a polynomial? It depends on the power of polynomial. The greatest power, like the power is 3 here. That's why the number of zeros for this polynomial is 3. If we have a quadratic polynomial like px equals to x square plus 5x plus 6, then the number of zeros are 2. Which are 2? By using material time splitting method, we can easily calculate them, x plus 3 and x plus 2. When we are putting these two brackets equals to 0, we will get the zeros of this polynomial. Either x plus 3 equals to 0, this implies x equals to minus 3, and or x plus 2 equals to 0, then x equals to minus 2. These are the two zeros. So it depends on the power of that polynomial, how many zeros appear there. Now, the verification. Suppose we have a polynomial px is ax square plus bx plus c. We have a quadratic polynomial here like this, ax square plus bx plus c, and two zeros are alpha and beta of this one. For the verification, we are testing for two things. The first one is sum of zeros. that is equals to minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square, that is alpha plus beta equals to minus b by d, and product of zeros is always given by constant divided by coefficient of x square, that is alpha into beta is equals to c by a. Suppose for that we have a quadratic polynomial like this. If we are comparing by this one, you will get the value of a, b, c here. A is 1. Coefficient of x square known as a, that is 1. B is 5. Coefficient of x is known as b. And this one is c, 6, constant one. And these two are zeros. We are taking them as alpha and beta. So for the verification, we are putting the values of alpha, beta, a, b, c in these two formulas. Sum, for the sum verification, alpha plus beta, which means minus 3 plus minus 2, should be equals to minus b by a, minus b, the value of b is 5 and value of a is 1. Minus 3 and minus 2 becomes minus 5, and here is minus 5 also. So LHS is equals to RHS. Similarly, if we have product, that is alpha into beta should be equals to c by a. What is alpha here? Minus 3. What about beta? Minus 2. C, the constant term, is 6, and a 1. Minus 3 into minus 2 becomes plus 6, and 6 divided by 1 is 6. LHS is equals to RHS. This is the verification process. तो हमारे पास कोई यदि एक क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलीनोमियल दिया हो तो बड़े डेमोंस्ट्रेटिंग से पहले उसके फैक्टर निकालते हैं, उनसे अल्फा और बीटा की वैल्यू मिल जाती है। एक्स स्क्वायर का कोएफिशिएंट ए, एक्स का कोएफिशिएंट बी और कांस्टेंट टर्म सी ले लेते हैं। वेरिफिकेशन फॉर्म में हमारे पास ये दो है, अल्फा प्लस बीटा इक्वल्स टू माइनस बी बाई ए, अल्फा बीटा इक्वल्स टू सी बाई ए। व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज ऑफ ए बी सी एंड अल्फा बीटा in these two formula, we are looking here LHS and RHS are equal. If they are equal, then our zeros are quite right, and if they are unequal, then something is wrong. You have to check that. Next thing, if two zeros are given us, then how we can calculate or evaluate the quadratic polynomial? Suppose we have two zeros alpha and beta, and the formula is taken as to get the polynomial px equals to x square minus sum of zeros multiplied by x plus product of zeros that is x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta. Suppose we are having example we are taking here, alpha is 4 and beta is minus 2. Putting these values here to get the polynomial. So px is equals to x square minus alpha plus beta. The value of alpha is 4 and beta is minus 2. X plus alpha into beta, that is the product of these two. So we have here x square minus 4 minus 2, 2. And 4 multiplied by minus 2, minus 8. This is our polynomial. So according to this process, we can easily calculate the polynomial. Suppose we have some other things like, if alpha is 2 plus root 3 and beta is 2 minus root 3, and we have to find out the polynomial. For that, first we are finding sum and product. So here alpha plus beta is 2 plus root 3 plus 2 minus the root 3. We are given root 3, cancel with root 3, 2 plus 2, 4, and their product 2 plus root 3 multiplied by 2 minus root 3. A plus B multiplied by A minus B, A square minus B square, which means 2 whole square minus root 3 whole square. That is 4 minus 3, 1. So the polynomial Px, according to this formula, substitute the value of alpha plus beta and alpha beta here. So px is x square minus alpha plus beta is 4 and alpha beta is 1. Answer. So according to this formula, we can easily calculate the equation of polynomial और एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ ए पॉलीनोमियल. तो ये हमारे पास तरीका है कि जब जीरोस हमें गिवन हो तो उसकी हेल्प से किसी पॉलीनोमियल को किस तरह से अपन इवैल्यूएट करते हैं. कल हम बात करेंगे द डिवीजन मेथड ऑफ पॉलीनोमियल्स.